Today I'm going to demonstrate how to make a blubber glove. All we need are two zipper seal bags, a 48 ounce tub of shortening, a large spoon, and some duct tape. You will notice that I have taken one of the zipper seal bags and I have actually turned it inside out. So we're going to set that one aside for the moment, and I'm going to start with my normal side out zipper seal bag. I'm going to take my shortening and I'm going to generously scoop the shortening into the bag. And the goal is to get as much shortening as I can from my 48 ounce container into my zipper seal bag. The more shortening that we have in there, the better the insulating factor is going to be when we use our blubber glove. Okay, I'm just going to take another scoop or two, and then we'll call it good enough. Okay, so my bag now has a generous amount of shortening inside it. A little extra shortening there on the lip that I don't need. I'll take my inside out bag, put my hand inside it, and then press it down into the bag that contains the shortening. And I want to try and sort of smush it into the shortening so that I can get it pretty evenly in there and lined up with the right side out bag. And if I do this carefully, I should be able to line up the zipper seals and actually attach the two bags together. I'm not going to rely on the zipper seal as the sole way of holding this together, but it'll be a good temporary hold while I'm taping it, which is going to be my final way to hold it together. Okay, so I've got that semi-attached. Now I'm going to take some duct tape, and I went ahead and cut a few pieces of duct tape. I'm going to start by taping the corner of the two bags together and the other corner. And then I'm going to take some long strips of duct tape and use them to overlap the long edges of the two bags. And you can be quite generous with the duct tape. You don't want to skimp on that, because this is how you're going to keep from having accidents and getting shortening all over everything and everybody. Okay, I had paused the video there while I finished applying the duct tape. And the last thing that I'm going to do is press the shortening around so that I have a relatively even layer between the two bags. This is going to be important because when we use the blubber glove as an insulator and we press it into, or we set it into our container of water, we want to make sure that we don't have any gaps in the shortening, because of course that will let the cold water be felt by somebody who has their hand inside the blubber glove. Okay, so our blubber glove is set and ready to use. So to actually use my blubber glove, I'm going to need a wash basin that has some cold water in it. You can see some ice cubes floating here. I'm going to set my blubber glove in there and make sure it stays upright. And then there are a number of different ways you can do this. You can have people place their hand inside the blubber glove and then take their other hand and place it in the water and see if they can notice a difference. You can use a thermometer that is set in the water and then a second thermometer that you put in the blubber glove, and you can ask students to read the two temperatures and notice the difference. So depending on the age of people that you're working with, the time that you've got, you could have a whole worksheet for students to do a calculation of the difference between the temperatures